dress is so big on me. It looks really so large.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand for the bride?
This is when I start crying.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. With this mask on, you can't see how big I'm smiling right now. Thank you for joining us on this beautiful day in this lovely setting to join David and Laura as husband and wife. While it was not the initial idea for the date or the ceremony, make no mistake, this is an important day. We've all had to adjust to some really complicated circumstances in the last 8 months. Today marks a new beginning, and I hope we all embrace that. This is not a fixed gap. It's an important event in these two lives, and I congratulate them. This gathering is made up of all the people that have played important parts in your lives. Each of them, family and friends, are the first act that has led you to be the couple that you are today. You opened the second act on Broadway. And these lucky ticket holders are here for the rest of the show. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for being the audience on opening night. David and Laura, the rest of the show is yours to write. Make it a blockbuster. Let us also remember those who could not be here today. Excuse me. Because of physical distance, spiritual distance, or state mandate regarding large gatherings of people. Know that they are thinking about you both because of the lasting difference you have made in their lives and are wishing you well on this wonderful day. And rest assured, we will do this again on a summer day, where we can all hug each other and dance. In the meantime, the ceremony is being streamed on YouTube. Marriage is a constant work in progress. It is important to constantly find ways to reconnect with your spouse and strengthen your bond. In that vein, I'd like to ask you to hold hands. These are the hands of your best friend, strong and vibrant with love, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love and cherish each other through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will love you passionately and with the slightest touch comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief engulfs your heart. I hate dinner. Can I get a chair?
Yeah.
I'm about to fall down.
Here. Just sit
down. Thank you.
We got it.
I'm very sorry.
Oh, no. You're fine. There you go.
I've been working from home. I've been sitting down for 8 months. Okay. These are the hands that will give you strength and support when you just can't do it alone. These are the hands that, when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Laura and David have come here together to learn the best of what each other has to offer, appreciating their differences and confirming that being together is far better than being apart. As we bless this marriage and this family, the symbol of a new home is consummated. Your family will rely on you to keep the love you feel for each other today alive and well, and to surround them with the joy that you find in each other. Keep the light you see in each other foremost in your mind. David and Laura, as you speak your vows today that will unite you in matrimony, remember all your friends and family. By joining with you today, know that you will never be alone. Who gives this woman to be wed?
Her mother and dad.
Thank you. These are the promises to last a lifetime. Laura and David, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yeah.
As I'm who you ask.
Yes.
We have.
Lauren David, since it is your intention to enter into marriage, please recite the vows that you have composed. David first.
Oh, she was going to go
first. Okay, go first.
Where are yours?
David, I am so happy to get to marry you today. We started our relationship less than 2 months before I started 4 years of optometry school in Columbus. I have a note here that you wrote me at the end of our first summer in 2013. I won't read the whole thing. It says, you left for Columbus today, so I'm a little bit sad, but I'm so happy to have you. I feel so lucky. I know I've said all of that before, but saying it doesn't get old. I've never felt like this before, and it's absolutely amazing. I love you so much that I can't even really express it. And then there's a PS at the bottom that says, when you said, I can't wait for a million more adventures together, my heart melted. I can't wait either, Laura. And look at the adventures we've had since then. Your commitment to our relationship was beyond amazing during those 4 grueling years in school. You proved your love when you had to find street parking every weekend in the ruthless, so happy outskirts of OSU's campus, spending our weekends in the library or our favorite study spot, Giant Eagle Market District. The craft beer bar there helped.
Yep.
Now we have our sweet home, our cherished little doggy, and our beautiful life together. Thank you for always making me laugh, for supplying the soundtrack to our life, which is any song, with every lyric replaced with Mooney Boons. I'll gladly take your sleep talking and your receipt hoarding every day of the week if it means we get to continue this wonderful life together. I admire so many things about you, how you'll drop anything to help your loved ones and sometimes even strangers, how hard you work every day to support our little family, and how loving and understanding you are. I promise to always be there for you as you have for me. I cannot wait to continue our travels, expand our family, and like the note says, to have a million more adventures together. I love you and I'll love you forever.
Do I go now?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. How can I express those overwhelming feelings that I have for my soon-to-be wife and loving partner during these crazy times? How can I possibly put the love that I have for the woman of my dreams into words? Is what I asked Alexa a few months ago. She didn't have an answer for me. So I did what you love about me so much, and I put writing my vows off until later. In fact, that night, I don't know if you remember, but you were in the kitchen with me as I continued to try to get Alexa to help me figure out what to write. After I gave up, we cooked dinner, and I went on to the garage after you turned on whatever Great British House Hunter Boat Bachelor Wives show you were watching at the time. While I was out in the garage, I was working with my miter saw. If you're familiar with my propensity to injure myself, you'll not be surprised to hear that this saw frequently kicks sawdust off the wall behind it and right into my eyes. Thanks to you, I have about 1 billion pairs of safety glasses in the house now, and I donned a pair before working with the saw. It was at that moment, while putting on my safety glasses, I was overcome by how thankful I was to have you. Not only because you've flushed and picked many bits of material for my eyes over the last few years, but because of the person and partner that you are. I suddenly remembered why I fell in love with you, and I just stood there reminiscing about all the fun we've had so far. Thankfully, the saw was not running at the time, or I may have cut a finger off, and I wouldn't have one to put the ring on. As I stared out the garage door, I thought about kissing you the first time on the beach, about all the trips we've gone on. Sorry. All the events we've gone to, the shows we've seen, laughs we've shared, and tears we've shed. I thought about all the weekends spent in Columbus, eating at Buckeye Donuts, going to dollar movies, attending OSU games, and of course studying. Well, you studied, but I played video games. I thought about the day we moved you back to Akron, to your home, to your family, and to me, and a day that I thought would not come soon enough. Sorry. We finally made it through the long distance relationship, and we started our next chapter together, side by side. I thought about starting our respective careers together, buying a house together, adopting Mooney together, and eating salad after salad after salad after salad together for the last few weeks in preparation for this moment. Writing these vows, I continued to think about the times we've had together and was overwhelmed by the sense of thankfulness that I have and the comfort I get knowing you are by my side. I could not have asked for a stronger woman, a better partner, and a more caring friend to tackle the future with. When I look into your eyes, I see love, I see joy, and I see hope. We can get through anything, and we will do it together. I love you, I promise to always love you, and I promise no matter what the future may bring, I'll always be by your side.
Wow. You are now taking into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in all the world that you love best. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of deep trust as well. With the exchange of rings, you agree to share your strength, responsibilities, and your abiding love. Mr. Mooney.
Yeah.
Can I hold
hers? Yes.
What? Oh. This here.
No. Laura, as you place the ring on David's finger, repeat after me. With this ring, I join my life with yours.
With this ring, I join my life with yours.
It is my promise.
It is my promise.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
I give you my heart. I have no greater gift to give.
I give you my heart. I have no greater gift to give.
I am honored to call you my husband and to say this is my beloved and this is my best friend.
I am honored to call you my husband and say this is my beloved and this is my best friend.
Thank you.
David? With this ring, I join my life with yours.
With this ring, I join my life with yours.
It is my promise.
It is my promise.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
From this day forward, you will not walk alone.
I give you my heart. I have no greater gift to give.
I give you my heart. I have no greater gift to give.
I am honored to call you my wife and to say this is my beloved, this is my friend.
I am honored to call you my wife and to say this is my beloved, this is my friend.
As you wear these rings, whether you are together or apart for even just a moment, let them be a constant reminder of the vows you have spoken today. You have shown your love and affection by joining hands and making promises of faith and devotion. May you talk together through all things. May you always feel deeply loved because you are. Laura, keep laughing at his jokes. And David, kiss her on the forehead after a long day. Your hearts will be your shelter and each other's arms will be your home. May you feel the joy you feel today forever. One last thing. I'd like you both to take a second and look into each other's eyes. Think about how you're feeling right now and what you see there. Remember this moment. Save it in your heart and mind. In difficult times, remember this look. It will serve you well. David and Laura, you have kissed thousands, if not millions, of times, but today, this moment, it is a whole new kiss. No longer simply partners and best friends. You are now, as I declare by the power vested in me by the state of Ohio, and in the eyes of God, husband and wife. Please kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor and pleasure to present David and Laura.
Thank you.
up.
Thank you. I'm sorry. I thought I was going to go down.
Everybody that can.
How'd you make this little shit out of it
anywhere? I told you beforehand.
Names are on the cards.
Still fish in the lake.
Not much anymore. Last time I was in that lake, I fell in.
Oh no.
Didn't have a good time.
That's
not bad. There.
I'll stop recording.
Yeah, stop recording.